Hello students, myself Pushpalata Kadam from Samarpan Gyan School. Today we are going to study EVS Class 3 Chapter 2 The Plant Fairy. Students, we see different types of plants around us, right? Are they all same? No, they are different, right? They are different types of plants. Okay. So let's study the different types of plants which we see around us. The plants are of different types. Some plants are very small. They have a thin stem, weak stem, tender stem, thin green stem. Okay, such plants which are small, which have weak stem, thin stem, are called herbs. Example of herbs are tulsi, mint. Your mother adds coriander leaves to the food, tasty food, right? So coriander is also an example of herb, and mint is also an example of herb, right? The next type of plants are the shrubs. What are shrubs? Shrubs are little bigger than herbs. Okay, they have many branches. Their stem is thicker than the herb, and these plants are about your size, not very small, not very big. Example is rose plant, hibiscus plant, right? Have you seen rose plant, hibiscus plant? They are not very big. The stem is also not very thick, not very thin. Okay, such plants are called shrubs. They have many branches. The branches arises from the bottom of the stem. And such plants are called shrubs. Examples of shrubs are rose, hibiscus, jasmine. All these are examples of shrubs. And what are trees? Tall plants, big plants are called trees. Right? In the picture, you can see the first picture is of a tree. How is the stem of a tree? A tree has a thick woody stem. Right? And it has branches, but the branches are on the upper side of the stem, right? On the upper side, there are branches, and the stem is thick, woody. This thick, woody stem of a tree is called trunk. It is called trunk, right? Can you give me some examples of trees? Examples of trees are mango tree, banyan tree, peepal tree, neem tree. Okay, so these are the examples of trees, right? So herbs are very small plants. They have weak stem. Example, coriander, tulsi, mint. Shrubs are plants which are about your size. Not very small, not very big. They have many branches rising from the bottom of the stem. And they have a little thicker stem than the herb. Okay, examples of shrubs are rose, hibiscus, jasmine, etc. And trees are the tall, big plants, and they have thick, woody stem, right? Examples of trees are banyan tree, mango tree, peepal tree. Okay? Children, do you know? Some plants are having very weak stem. The stem is so weak that these plants cannot stand straight. So what do? They take support of some other plant to climb up. Can you name any such plant which takes the support of a bamboo or wall, or they take the support of electric poles to climb up? They even take supports of big trees to climb up. These plants are called climbers. Example is money plant. Have you seen a money plant? It takes the support of a bamboo or a stick to climb, or even they take the support of a rope to climb. So they are called climbers. They have weak stem. The stem is very weak, which cannot stand straight, upright. It cannot stand upright. So they take the support of some other thing, right? What are the examples of climbers? One I already told you, that is a money plant, then pea plant, then bottle gourd, What else? Bottle gourd, bitter gourd, grapevine. All these are the examples of climbers. Okay. Some plants, they also have very weak stem. They cannot stand straight. But what they do? What do they do? They creep on the ground. They don't take support of something, but they creep on the ground. See, in this last picture, what is this picture about? This is a pumpkin, right? And have you seen a pumpkin plant? It creeps on the ground. That is, it spreads on the ground. Such plants are called creepers. What are the other examples of creepers? Some other examples of creepers are watermelon, muskmelon. Okay, these are the examples of creepers. See children, this is a pumpkin. Can you see? This is an example of a creeper. Right? Plants, they grow in different habitats. Like some plants, they grow in water. Right? They are water plants like water lily, etc. And some plants, they grow on the ground. Right? So, plants are of different types. The plants which grow in water are called aquatic plants. Right? And what about the leaves? Do all plants have the same type of leaves? See in this picture. These are the leaves of different plants. Are they all same? No, they are different. Leaves are of different kinds. Right? Some leaves are very small. Some are big. Some are long. Some are round. Okay. Some are triangular. And what about the colors? They also have different colors. Right? Some are light green. Some are dark green. Some are even yellow, red and purple. Okay. Some leaves have patches on them. White patches. Red patches. Can you see in this picture? So, they are of different types. And see the margins of these leaves. How are the margins? Are they same? No, the margins are also different. Right? Some have straight margins. And some have uneven margins. Right? Some of these margins even look like a saw. Saw is used by carpenter to cut wood. Right? So, just like that the leaves have the margin. Right? So, there are different types of leaves. They have different colors, shapes and margins. Okay. Children, do you know the uses of leaves? Leaves are used for different purposes. For what do we use leaves? Can you name the uses of leaves? Some leaves like tulsi, neem are used as medicine. Right? When you have cold, cough, your mother uses tulsi leaves. Okay? And if you have some skin problem, then we use neem leaves. Neem also has medicinal properties. Then bitter leaves are eaten for bad breath. Right? So, can you name some other uses of leaves? Leaves of curry leaves. That is, curry leaves are used in food to give nice flavor to the food. Then coriander leaves, mint leaves are also added to food to give a nice aroma to food. Right? So, in this way, leaves are of different uses. That is, there are different uses of leaves. Leaves of coconut, dried leaves of coconut are used to weave baskets, mats. Right? Leaves are also used to make huts. Okay, they are used to make roofs of huts. See children, this is a picture of a banana leaf. Can you see for what it is used? It is used to serve food. Banana leaves are used as plates to serve food. Right? Leaves are also useful for plants because they prepare food for plants. Right? By the process of photosynthesis. What is photosynthesis? Photosynthesis is a process by which plants prepare their own food. They use carbon dioxide, oxygen, water and sunlight and chlorophyll to prepare their own food. This process is called photosynthesis. In this process, plants take in carbon dioxide and give out oxygen. And you all know that human beings, plants and animals, they need oxygen. Oxygen is very useful. So plants give us oxygen, and oxygen makes the air fresh. So in this way, leaves are also useful because they keep our atmosphere clean and fresh. See children, there is an activity for you. In this activity, what is done here? Dry leaves are used to make pictures of different animals. You can also do this activity. You should collect dry leaves and paste them to make pictures of different animals. This is activity for you, and all of you should do it. Okay. There is another one activity, that is rubbings. You have to take a leaf and make rubbings. How to make rubbings? You can do it using a crayon or color pencil. Place a leaf on a table or ground, and it should be placed in such a way that the side of the leaf with veins is on the top. Place the paper on the leaf and gently rub the crayon or color pencil on the paper, and you will get such type of rubbings. In the similar way, you can take rubbings of the bark of a tree, that is the trunk of a tree. Okay, so you will enjoy doing all these activities. Have you understood this lesson, children? Read the lesson and practice reading. Thank you.